So I'm going to go first because we've discussed it and we've mentioned it a couple of times tonight, Sky Stream. No, they're not sponsoring this podcast. They did send me some biscuits, which were very nice.
So you've admitted the biscuits are good. Right,
yeah, they were very nice. My review of the biscuits is good. The Sky Stream, patchy. So basically, the stream box is basically the brains behind the glass TV, and it comes without a satellite dish. So it has its own user interface, the way that the menus are laid out and so on. It's a little bit different to Sky Q. I do have Sky Q here in these premises as well, so I've been able to do some A and B and backwards and forwards. The main thing, the main problem I have here is that I'm using a 4G internet box from Three in here. Obviously, in the office that I'm using, it's a full system, very, very fast. This one, 40 meg down, 5 meg up, so not particularly great. Trying to watch UHD football over the weekend in HDR was a chore. It kept stuttering, it kept stopping, it would stop completely and then pick up again 3 minutes, which when you're trying to watch a football game doesn't work. And of course, the satellite system, the Sky Q system, no interruptions in the broadcast, still in UHD, HDR. So it definitely comes down to your internet. That was wired as well, not wireless. I did use an Ethernet cable into the box. Now, obviously, the caveat there is I'm using a 4G box. You need good internet for this if you're going to watch live UHD. The rest of this stuff, perfectly fine. A lot of the streaming apps, and this is the beauty of the Sky Stream, is it brings all your apps together. So you got Netflix, Disney Plus, Prime, anything you think of is basically on the box. The whole UI system is based on what it is you want to watch. So it doesn't just push Sky content onto you. It will show you Disney Plus, it will show you Star, it will show you Prime. It'll even show you Freeview stuff, so you know, Channel 4, BBC, all that kind of thing. It will. Why is it when I start talking, we get the best adult dating sites popping up?
Because you're irresistible, Phil.
I thought that. So anyway, stop spamming. Sky Stream, it looks great. Functionality-wise, in terms of you know content aggregation and in front of you, it's a great idea. The thing is, you have to sign up to all these apps. You have to have accounts with these apps and. I've got a thanks guy that because of the sent it for review, it came with a full package. So I've got absolutely everything on there and I can use it the way it's intended to be used. And it really does work quite well when you're just watching, you know, HD broadcast and that kind of thing. It doesn't stutter, it doesn't cause any issues. 4K still looks good. Netflix, Disney Plus, I didn't have any problems streaming from those.
Any Dolby Vision with that film?
Dolby Vision. Atmos was missing with the sport on the UHD. Now, it was on the Sky Q box, but it wasn't flagging on the TV as being Atmos from the stream. So I'm not sure what the differences are there. Ian got all the bump, which I'll have to get because I didn't go on the launch. So there maybe is a reason why it doesn't do Atmos with the sport channel. I don't know. I'm testing it with a Panasonic LZ2000, a 55-inch at the minute. And like I say, interface-wise, using it with that TV, and this is the whole idea, it's so you don't have to go with your Sky Glass TV, you can use any TV with it. I like the idea, I like the way the content is aggregated together and you can find things easy. The voice control, little microphone, you ask it a question and it'll bring up everything across all of the apps related to the content. So if you say, give me a film of Harrison Ford, it won't just bring you back Sky Cinema, it'll also bring back Film 4, it'll bring back any of the terrestrial channels that films are on. And so in that respect, it's really, really good. Sport-wise, like I say, I got given the full package with this. So there's BT Sport and Sky Sports and so on. Again, plenty of choice. If you've got a poor internet like I have at this this house here, stick to HD and it's fine. If you try and go 4K with the live stuff, like I say, if you haven't got a great internet, it does tend to stutter and judder around a little bit. But yeah, I mean, the full review will be coming soon. Like I say, I'm benchmarking it against the Sky Q box that I've had here for a while, which is satellite based. So in terms of image quality, I haven't seen any difference Yeah, in image quality, compression's exactly the same. It's always been a blocky mess with movies and fade to blacks and so on. It's the same on the Sky Q box as it is on the Stream box. I think these are things that you kind of accept with this at this moment in time. You either love it or hate the convenience. If you're looking for a serious system, obviously it's not for serious movie watching and so on because of the issues with Sky's compression. It's something I've always complained about. But for the convenience side of things, if you're just sitting down on a Friday night and you just want to, you know, veg out and watch something, it's a great way of finding content. And it's the size of an Apple TV, little box that just sits under the TV. HDMI connector, there's an Ethernet connector and an RF for TV channels. So yeah, full review coming soon, so that's all right. Ian went to the launch. Ian, anything I've forgotten to mention there?
I think that covers most of it. Obviously, the website, the news story is up on the website. It just covers all the key details that Sky were willing to talk about at launch. But no, nothing else to add. Sounds good.
There is one question I have, gentlemen.
Go on.
Is there any, was there any indication at all if this is seen as a successor to, you know, the Now TV platform? I mean, the two going to continue to, is Now TV going to continue to wobble alongside it, or is the eventual plan that, you know, televisions ship with something approaching this platform on board and it's a more cohesive sort of cross Sky experience?
I can't answer that question directly because I don't know. What I will tell you about this is that you need a separate subscription for it. So if you have Sky Q, you can't just add one of these pucks. You have to have a separate account for the Sky Streams puck. So it you need to have two subscriptions, basically. If you've already got Sky Q, it won't run alongside this, which I did find a little bit confusing because they phoned me up the VIP line to switch it on. And I said, well, can you just put it onto my existing account? And it was like, no, it has to be completely separate. So yeah, if you're going for Sky Stream, it is it's a completely separate subscription. It's not connected to anything else you might have with Sky, like a Q box or whatever. As for Now TV, I don't know, Ed, is the honest answer.
I mean, it would seem logical, but then Sky doesn't always do logical.
No.
So we'll still wait to see, I guess.
No, and the thing that surprised me a lot about Sky is that they used to be at the forefront when it came to broadcast technology. They were always the one pushing the envelope and pushing other broadcasters to keep up. It seems to be that they're now just concerned with Premier League and being able to buy the rights for those games. And it seems that because of that, they are lagging a little bit behind. It's nice to see this technology, but it's about 3 years too late, if you ask me. They seem to be resting on the laurels, basically, and not pushing it. So it's a really nice proposition. I need to use it a little bit more. I've only used it over the weekend. It only arrived on Wednesday or Thursday last week. So yeah, I need to use it a little bit more. But it's promising, and it's a decent solution. And Michael said in the comments, and I think he's correct, that you can have a number of these stream boxes. I don't know about the account, so that's something I'm going to have to speak to Sky about. But obviously with Sky Q, you're limited to just the main box, being UHD, HDR. The mini box doesn't do that.